Hello, you're very welcome to Gerry's DIY. This is really dangerous. I've got a copper cylinder sitting over my waste oil burner. It's just to show that, you know, if you want, you can make a ton of hot water. Now, you wouldn't be doing it this way because it's dangerous. Now, I just shut off the oil there for a bit and pulled out the power because it got a bit strong. But it's going away there, no problem. And in a minute, we'll be making hot water. Now, the problem with this is, I had to take the tap out, so this is open vented essentially. What's going to happen is it's going to make steam, we'll see steam, and I'm going to end it there at that. But some of the water is going to go down and mix with the oil, so it's dangerous, you know. But just thought I'd give it a shot. Now, I'm going to set this up inside. I've already started a project a while ago, and I'm going to set something like this up inside, but it's going to be a lot more controllable. On this setup now, you could easily have cold water going into the bottom of that cylinder, that hot water tank, with the top capped and, you know, water flowing through continuously. You'd need safety valves and so on it just to stop it blowing up, or you'd want it open vented, preferably open vented. We've got the hot gases from the flames going, you know, wrapping, enveloping the copper cylinder, which has water. It's not full, but it's about, you know, it's got this much water. So it's 27 gallons, so a third of that, nine gallons of water thereabouts. So anyway, there you go. Looks crap, but would make an absolute ton of heat. I had the flames coming up along the sides of that. I gave it a bit too much oil, and you can see that the copper cylinder is black. Now, if you were seriously doing this, you'd have all this insulated and you'd have controls on it. This is as dangerous as it gets, so don't do this. I'm just doing it for the fun, and I'm out in the middle of the garden, so, you know, and nothing can blow up because it's not sealed. I'll just show you the setup now on the other camera. Okay, so it's like having a big pot on the boil. I've got the pot down there. And that'll burn away all day, no problem. Now, we all know copper is a great conductor of heat, and I'm relying on that. This has silver soldered seams and so on, but with the water inside, it won't allow it to get red hot, otherwise it would melt. Not necessarily the copper, because I think that melts around 1,000 degrees, but the silver solder probably melts around 600 or 700 degrees. Now, we're hemorrhaging heat all over the place on this one. The outer walls of that oil drum are, you know, open to the atmosphere, they're losing heat. And also the way that this thing is set up. But we're making a ton of heat, so boiling water, no problem. And doing it with waste oil. So if that system was put into an oil boiler, you know, something designed for this, you could make an awful lot of heat and an awful lot of hot water for radiator systems or anything like that. Now, I've been asked about this fan as well. This fan is 320 watts. You know, you don't need something so big. It's just, I happen to have it. I don't have a smaller one. But it's making a ton of heat. Waste oil burner in a barrel, in a garden, you know, no problem whatsoever. Now, I won't let this thing pressurize. As soon as it makes steam, that's it, I'll plug everything out. So this isn't the cleanest or most efficient way of burning waste oil. There are more efficient ways, and I've done it, I've burned it cleanly. But I'm just doing this as a simple mock-up, if you like, to show you like a start position. You can be as crude as you like and still achieve results with this. You gotta be careful though. So we're at about 97 degrees centigrade at the top of the cylinder. At some stage, we're going to hit 100 degrees, and that's it, we'll get plenty of steam. Still making a ton of heat. So there you go, this copper cylinder is rated at 40 psi. We have an open vented system, and we're not making anywhere near 40 psi. So at the moment, I'm safe enough to be here, but, you know, and we're doing that with waste oil. We're doing it with a very rudimentary, very basic burner. And you can see it's going really well. So no question as to whether we're making 100 degrees C. I'm not going to leave this going for much longer now. That's more or less it. At this point, you know, this is not safe. So there you go, very basic waste oil burner, very basic waste oil water heater, you know, waste oil boiler. But very easy to make. We just literally, if you can put a pot on the stove in a house, you know, on your cooking stove, this is more or less it. So I'm just going to shut everything off now before we start making too much pressure. But that's essentially it. Look, we're making a ton of steam, we're making a ton of heat, we're using just waste oil and some very basic tools to knock this up. Total cost practically zero. But look, I'm going to leave it there at that. If you liked the video, please thumbs up, subscribe down here if you wouldn't mind. If you're already a subscriber, thanks very much. It's great having you around. Numbers are growing, which is amazing. And I'll see you all in the next video. Good luck. Bye.